Come on, Levy. You rehearse like everybody else.
I'm gonna get me a band and make me some records.
Go ahead, playing music.
I know what I'm doing.
When I got there, they began to say,
that's to get the people's attention.
Since this film is going to provide a lasting image of Chadwick Boseman for many audiences, just due to his being his final film released, is there a memory for making the film and working with him that stands out in your mind?
Him playing his djembe drum. You know, the djembe drum is an African drum that's called the talking drum because, you know, it's sort of whoever plays it, whatever is in their soul comes out in how they play it. And he would do it for his own healing. He said, it was just for me, viola. And he'd carry it around. He said he even brought it to Thailand when he shot The Five Bloods. You know, whenever he traveled, it was, you know, on the plane with him. You could tell he protected it. And on set, he played it in this trailer. And, you know, there was something very, and I know he's a spirit, he was a very spiritual man, very much, you know, huge believer in God. So it was, for me, it was him talking to God.
How much he loved to rehearse, how much he loved to play that trumpet, how much he loved to just inquire August Wilson's rich text. And he was playful. He would walk in sort of like with a quiet grace, with his big old brim hat to the side and his trumpet, and usually these sort of harem pants, you know, right? so he just looked like a musician coming through. He didn't look like an actor. Yeah. He looked like you know, a musician coming through and just willing to play and willing to be open.
I will. That sly smile. You always knew something else was going on. He's always thinking, always watching, always present. Even, you know, and Coleman talks about this, when even when he was playing that trumpet, if the three of us were riffing on something, he'd just pop in.
Yeah, exactly.
He didn't miss a beat.
He knew exactly what we were talking about.
What we were talking about. So, yeah.
I love how caring he was and how wonderful he and his bride-to-be were together. I like to watch them being playful and or loving with one another. That had nothing to do with acting, you know. It had nothing to do with the story. It had nothing to do with where we were. It was just his world, you know. And it was wonderful to watch that part of his life.
Chadwick was so incredibly protective of Taylor Page, who was playing Dusty May, and I was just so moved by how protective and careful he was when dealing with her. Not that she's fragile, but he just wanted her to feel very safe. So that sticks out. I mean, I think the first time that he allowed August Wilson's language to affect him when we were rehearsing and he became so emotionally available to the material, the laughter and the fun that he had with the other band members, while we were filming and while we were waiting around, you know, there was such joy and fun that he brought to it. And just the ferocity and that ferocity he had as an actor and in turn as a human being, and the sense of responsibility he felt to dig in and give every single thing he had to make Levy live and to go wherever the character required that he needed to go.
I got style.
Oh, everybody got style. Style ain't nothing but keeping the same idea from beginning to end. Everybody got it.
Everybody can't play like I do.
I really liked how Ma kind of switched throughout the film between being the protagonist and the antagonist, almost moment to moment. And I'm curious if you view her as more one or the other.
I don't. I don't view her as a protagonist or antagonist. Because I can't. An actor doesn't do that. It's like, you got to portray the character exactly who they are, whether they're a protagonist or an antagonist. It's for the audience. That's a judgment. I portrayed her as a woman who literally is born in a world that doesn't value her at all, that doesn't even recognize her as a human being. But she is a person who understands her worth.
But if they want to call me Mother Blues, that's all right with me. It don't hurt none.
So therefore, she's a woman that absolutely has busted a hole through 1927. She is a liberated woman. She is those people that you don't know where the hell they came from. You know, it's like, where were you born? So I just saw her as a woman who knew her worth and wasn't going to concede. It wasn't up for discussion. I know that I'm great at what I do. I know it's making you money. I should be called the mother of the blues. I'm influencing all these other singers. So you treat me like I deserve to be treated. And that's it.
We ready to go in 15 minutes.
We're ready to go. And Madam says we're ready to go. And that's the way it go around here.
The studio space in this film almost acts like a character also. And I feel like that really resonates because we feel like we're in the studio with the characters. How did you connect with that, the location and environment, to help that feel authentic?
Well, that's really great. I mean, so the band room, I really wanted to craft to subliminally suggest a boxing ring. So there were these four posts. So anytime the guys were going at each other with language, I wanted it to feel like a series of rounds.
Yeah.
And then in the band room, and where the recording studio was going on, I wanted to sense that once upon a time, this had been a factory that had been turned into a recording studio. And also, it was interesting enough, Ma Rainey recorded, when she recorded in Chicago, she recorded for Paramount Records, and Paramount Records had legendarily inferior equipment. And it was situated behind a chair manufacturing plant. And so we created that on the street. So they're trying to give out these hints and details of what was, while at the same time giving ourselves permission to play and be evocative and create this hopefully complicated, compelling world.
When we got there and saw that space, oh my God, it was like, ooh.
Dungeon.
Yeah, like a dungeon.
It was like a dungeon. Like, oh my goodness.
And it's funny, as actors, you thought, you think with the scenic design, well, you know, you don't have to make it that small with the camera, you can feel that small. But George was like, I want it to feel that small, so I will make the room that small. So right. It was true to life.